So in this video today, guys, we're going to be downloading Source Linux, install it in Oracle VirtualBox, and then connect using an SSH tool. So for this tutorial, I'll be using PuTTY. You can use your favorite tool, right? So you want to go to getopensource.org, and we're going to be going with the desktop version. So we're going to be going with the Leap version. So select download. I'm going to be going with the offline image, which is about 4 GB. I'll be using the one for the Intel AMD processor. So I'll be going with the offline image. So select download. So I'm just going to start the download with my download manager. This may take a few minutes to complete. So the download has been completed. You want to launch your VirtualBox. So select create. Specify a name for your server. So I'm just going to call this one AuraDev. From the ISO image, you're going to browse for the file. So select other. So here in my downloads, I'm going to go with OpenSUSE Leap, right? Then select next. So here you're going to give it some memory. I'm going to give it about 10 megabytes. And I'm going to give it about 9 processors. Not megabytes, but 11 gigabytes of memory here. Then select next. For the hard disk, I'm going to give it about, say, 20 gigabytes. Then select next and then select finish. So here I'm just going to delete this one that I have here. Once that is done, select start. So here we're going to select installation and then select enter. So let's maximize the screen. Here we're going to select next. Yes, we're going to enable online repository. Select next to accept the defaults. For the desktop, you can go with anyone. I'm going to be going with the KDE. Then select next. These are the partitions that will be created by default. I am not going to make any change. So here I'm going to select next. Select next here. For the user, I'm going to call it Oracle. And for the password, I'm going to call it Oracle as well. So here, this will be the same password for the system administrator. So select next to continue. So it says it has a conflict with the username. So I'm going to change it to AuraDBA. Then select next. Yes, I want to really use that simple password. Then select install. Select install. This is going to take some time to install, so I will pause the video and resume once it's completed. So the installation has been completed and I can now launch my SUSE Linux. It will automatically come up for you. Now it's time for us to go on to the next step. In order for us to connect to our SUSE Linux, we need to configure our network. So first you want to check your computer and see what network you're on. So you can select start, type cmd to bring up the command prompt. And here you're going to type ipconfig. So basically this is the network you're on. And you're going to be changing the last octet. For the SUSE server, we can give it an IP of 10.0.0.77. Alright, so select start. We're going to go to settings, select system settings, scroll down to connections, scroll across, select IVP4. For the meta, change it from automatic to manual. Now for the DNS server, it's going to be 10.0.0.1. Now here, you're going to add the IP address. So we're going to be changing the last octet as mentioned, so it's 10.0.112, right? For the net mask, it's 255.0. And for the gateway, it's the same as the DNS. So it's 10.0.0.1. Now this will be dependent on the IP and the network of the computer that you're using. Select apply. Enter the root user password. So this would be the same as the user that you created initially. So I'm going to select OK. So we have two more things to do. We need to disable the firewall and then we also need to install the OpenSSH client. So bring up the console. So here we're going to use the command sudo zipper install noconfirm OpenSSH. However, this may fail. Enter the Oracle password. So basically it has been installed already. So to disable the firewall, use the command sudo systemctl disable firewall. Now the firewall has now been disabled. So now you can launch PuTTY or your SSH tool. Specify your IP. Then you select open. So we are still not able to connect, so we have another change to make. So let's stop the VM, or off. So here on the server, select settings, go to network, and instead of NATed, select bridge adapter. Under advanced, for promiscuous mode, select allow all and then select OK. Now here, you can go ahead and start your machine again. Now let's try again using SSH. So let's restart. And now we can successfully reach our database. So here I was successfully able to log into my server using the AuraDBA user and the password. So that's it for now guys. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.